Today I want to talk to you about the power of a bad reputation. You know that old Hebrew saying, a good name is to be desired more than silver? I think it's also important to remember that, as Lao Tzu said in Taoism, he says that if it were not ridiculed, it would not be the true Tao. So if the Tao is not ridiculed, then it's not the true Tao. In fact, the clever can't understand it. The simple do. And so it's ridiculed. And so that which is ridiculed is the true Tao. So too, if we're ridiculed, maybe we're being our truest self. We who wander in the wilderness, scorn the first history of man, George Miller's Mad Max. Chiron himself wrote about the luster of dishonor that entertains and intrigues. It's dishonor that entertains you. It's dishonor that intrigues you. Somebody with a sparkly, shiny reputation, that's quite boring. In fact, Chiron writes that virtue is neither charming nor suited for biography. So, like, if you're virtuous, you may have a squeaky clean reputation, but you're not going to have a biography. You're not going to be charming in the way that villains so often are. Not only villains, but people with complicated reputations, such as the case all the way back to Moody Achilles, baneful wrath. That's what marked Achilles. Or deceitful, duplicitous Odysseus, who was distracted and spent time with the witch of the sea. Or Odysseus, who was known as quote unquote hubristic, angered the gods. Quote unquote bad reputations make for the best stories. And that's very comforting, because sometimes people will just, they'll slice and dice. They'll drag your name through the mud and there's nothing you can do about it. That's okay. Bad reputations make for the best stories. And perhaps this is why so many people are omniverts and ambiverts. We toggle between solitude and solidarity, because what is true of history, spiral dynamics, is reflected in the microcosms of our own stories. Just as you go red, blue, purple, orange, etc., back and forth between solitude and solidarity historically with spiral dynamics, so too we go back and forth, toggle back and forth between solidarity and solitude. We become ambiverts and omniverts so often, even more than introverts or extroverts, because we need to toggle back and forth between humans, because we understand, and then solitude after solidarity, because we understand that humanity, anthropologically speaking, is laughable, but we're amused and can be made to laugh from them, because we understand that it's not to be taken seriously. So again, we know the judgments of mob rule are laughable, and yet we want people to make us laugh. Hence, we don't care whether people vilify us or if they cast aspersions on our name, seeing as how we can just as soon revert back to our own private bubble and emerge when it's time for some anthropological amusement. People are not to be taken with anything other than levity when it comes to mob rule. And then you're just amused by people. You really don't take it seriously, because even if they cast aspersions on your name, even if they level railing accusations against you, that's okay. Be amused by it, because bad reputations make for the best stories, a la Achilles and Odysseus.